All right, study time.
Please, Mother, can I play first? I'm ready for the test. Please, Mother, please.
Well, I have been pleased with your progress. Just for a few minutes. And stay close to the house.
I'll be careful, Mother.
I came in first!
Yay!
I won! First prize, Good afternoon.
You frightened me.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. I'm a little bit nervous with that crazy wolf running around, you know. Would you like some tea?
Sure.
Hello, Mr. Woodsman. Look, he brought my skates. Oh. Did you fix them?
Just need a little oiling, is all. You hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Nothing at all. Little Red was just about to study her history.
I hate history.
Oh, I love history. I love it almost as much as I love forestry. The best way to learn about the future is to study the past.
How do you happen to know about history?
I went to Harvard.
Didn't the wolf go to Harvard too?
Yes. We tied telephones in our class. He was writing his senior thesis on Wolfgang Mozart when he was expelled for attentioning another student from Radcliffe. Then he moved out here and I went to Yale School of Forestry. He preys upon the forestman. I studied to protect it. Granny and I were calling Miss Royal. I'd better get back to my forest lookout tower. Thanks for the tea.
No problem. Goodbye. It's about time you started studying for your history. Now open the book and begin. You have a big test coming up, and I want you to do your best.
Yes.
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 common man.
Trees make room for me. The hummingbirds, how much go back to the main road.
Naughty writer!
Who are you?
The axe select the vocalist and music is out.
You don't belong in the forest if you can't dance and sing.
Well, I'm Little Red and I'm taking this basket to Granny. I'm a true lady.
Be back to the forest! Be in you belong!
Mother says that the woods are dangerous, but there are wolves.
You cannot behold the beauty unless you risk the danger. Aren't you, Little Red Riding Hood?
Yes.
I remember your mother. She used to come here with your father. I've never seen two people so much in love.
The whole forest stood in awe of them.
But the forest is not for everyone.
I don't understand.
It's not where the home is, it's where the heart is.
You must appreciate
and enjoy the forest.
And when you enjoy
and sing,
then you belong like the birds and the trees and everything in the forest that celebrates life.
Girls who I'm not as bad as I sound when I sing. Now, do I look mean to you?
Yes,
Dad.
Yes, no.
Well, I guess it just depends on your point of view.
Nothing but a super friendly, kindly, and hospitable hound dog, little lady. Just an old pooch. Call me Fido.
You look like a wolf to me.
Well, I see you're far too smart to be fooled by the likes of me. Yes, my dear, I am a wolf. Oh, but don't be afraid. I'm no ordinary. I'm a perfectly wonderful wolf. I can sing a song or make up a rhyme. I can own a girl in a minute. Though, of course, my dear, I do not mean you. I'm a perfectly wonderful wolf. On my days off, study pays off. I may read a book by Schopenhauer.
Be thankful for the cast.
There's no use in chipping my beautiful white teeth on such a dried-up old turtle. I understand we're going to have a visitor. A young, tender, pretty visitor from Red Riding Hood who should be arriving very shortly.
Nonsense! You are missing four.
Oh, but first, I must dispose of you. Ah! Just the place. Such a handsome closet. Now, you won't mind waiting in the closet until your charming granddaughter and I have concluded our business. Let me escort you to the closet.
No, yes, no, please, no.
Creatures in the forest.
But you also met the wolf. That's the way the wolf
Ready?